I was going to introduce you, but she's just come on out here. These guys right here, best quartet in gospel music today. Make them welcome. Triumphant Quartet. Make them welcome. What a great night.
Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened to me. Can't imagine my life without you. Where I would be forevermore. I'm a thank you, Lord, that I've been redeemed. Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened to me.
If I only had one message.
If I only had one moment before my time was gone.
Oh, I'd wanna make it clear to everyone I leave behind. Let there be no doubt or any worry about the legacy of my life. Oh,
Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened to me. Can't imagine my life without.
Over death, king of righteousness.
So hallelujah.
Lord, I confess that I've been a criminal. I've stolen your breath and sang my own song. Lord, I confess that I'm far from innocent. These shackles I wear, I bought on my own. Scarlet sins had a crimson cost. You nailed my death to that old rugged cross. An empty slate at the empty grave. Thank God that stone was rolled away. Lord, I confess that I've been a prodigal. For your house, but I walk my own road. Then Jesus came and he tore down my prison walls. Death came to life when he called me by name.
Here he was, the son of a wealthy man. Out of his own lust and his own greed, he had wandered away from home. And now he has a job feeding pigs. But he, while there in that condition, he learned what the real life is all about. He was very humble. He became sorry. He said, I will arise and go to my father. My father has servants that have far more than I have. I'll go back to my father and I won't be his son anymore. I'll say, Father, when I get there, I'll become a servant if you'll only take me back. Well, when you get back home, what kind of reception are you going to get? He didn't know. So he staggered in his dirty, filthy, smelly clothes back toward the home that he'd left. And the scripture says, but when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. He didn't take him back as a servant. He took him as a son. And that's what God will do tonight for you. And if you have been in the church but have wandered away from the church and wandered away from God, come back to him tonight. He stands with open arms ready to receive you. With love and mercy and grace.
This is our homecoming. Heaven joins in with the glorious sound. And the great cloud of witnesses all gather round. Cause the ones that were lost are finally found. The Father is welcoming. This is our homecoming. Scarlet sins at a crimson cost. You nailed my death to that old.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I've heard it all my life, even had it memorized, but it was only words to me. Red letters on a page, just something people say, till it brought me to my knees. Those words in John 3:16. For God so loved the world, he gave his only Son away to save a rich life. To love the world means even me. How could he see my sin and forgive me even then? Who would pay that kind of price? Well, I've seen what mercy does. He found me where I was, and he gave his life for mine. For God so loved the world, he gave his only Son away, a way to save a wretch like me. Me, the one who needed grace, grace to cover every stain, stain that he no longer. Amazing to believe God so loved the world. Got yourself into, let me just tell you, Jesus still loves you tonight. Amen. And the great thing about it is, he doesn't just love you, he so loves you. Amen. I love that song. I don't know, man, we've just already been blessed to be here. I mean, the Primitive Quartet, the Inspirations, the Karen Peck and them. I mean, let's just give them another hand, because they just did a fantastic job. Sat back there and worshiped right along with you guys. It's been an awesome time, and God's just been really good to us already. I don't know if he told you or not, we're from a little place called Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, just right up the road there.
Many of you have been there several times. Probably been there, done that, and got the t-shirt, literally. Probably bought several things from Pigeon Forge. Hey, if you ever get up that way, and I don't know how many of you get up that way, and, you know, on vacation, and, you know, go to church, and I know most of you probably need it. Just saying. But anyhow, if you get up that way, want to go to church, we're going to invite you to our home church. It's there. It's called Connect Church. I know most of you probably go once or twice a year, so just come by and come by to our church. Connect Church. Connect Church. Part of a church plant. We helped start about 4 years ago. And no joke, planted it, and we started in a barn with about 30 people and a couple horses. And it has just exploded from there. We've seen God just move and save people. And I'm telling you, man, we're running a little over about 900 or 1,000 right now. And just amazing what to watch what God is doing in our little church. Yeah. So if you get up that way, come by and see us. Connect Church. Connect Church. I want to do something a little different tonight, if you'll allow me to. First, let me check Facebook. I'm joking. Calm down. Everybody calm down. You guys get mad for nothing. I want you to help me quote one of my favorite chapters in the Bible. Would you do that? Leviticus? I'm joking. You guys get mad for no reason at all. I want you to help me quote my favorite chapter in the Bible. It's Psalms 23. Okay? Now listen, we're going to do it King James Version, because I know that's the way most of you learned it. So I'm going to read it, and you're going to quote it. Believe me, it's going to work out better like that. So let's just start. Let's just do this. Let's just stop traffic out here with it. Let's say it's so loud that people are wondering what in the world is going on here in this church. I don't know if this has ever been quoted in this church. Doesn't matter, but let's just quote it as loud as we can possibly quote it. Ready? Let's do it like we mean it. Let's go. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Woo, y'all give yourself a hand, that was good. That's the best it's ever been, guys. Honestly, I love that. That was amazing. Somebody's been to Sunday school. You can tell. I love this chapter because I love the confidence that that David seemed to have in his Lord, right? I mean, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me. Confident that God was with him. Confident that God was with him. But you know, David also wrote Psalms 22 just one psalm over. And Psalm 22 starts off like this. My God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Now, I don't know how far apart these two psalms were written. It could have been years. It could have been months. It could have been weeks. More than likely, it was days. And if David is anything like me, it could have been moments. Because I can be having a really good moment with the Lord, and all of a sudden, my God. I was having a really good moment with the Lord today, and then I started driving downtown Chattanooga over here. And I was like, my God, my God. Where are you? Some of you drove through the same thing. You know exactly what I'm talking about. But in all seriousness, I dare say that some of you in here have experienced those moments where everything's going great spiritually. You're just right there, man. You're right there with the Lord. And then maybe you get a phone call that says, hey, I'm so sorry to tell you, but your husband passed. Or your wife passed. Or your mother, your father passed. Or God forbid, a son or a daughter. Or a grandchild. And maybe you're here tonight, and even just this week that's happened, or maybe something like this has happened. You've got a phone call and said, hey, the test didn't come back exactly like we'd hoped that they would. Can I just remind you tonight that in all of our circumstances, in all our situations, that God is still good. All the time, and all the time, God is good. All my life, He's been faithful. All my life, He's been so, so good. With every breath that I'm able, I'm going to sing of the goodness of God. I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I'm able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night, you were close like no other. I've known you as a father, and I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. Anybody else?
So good. With every breath
Thank him for his goodness tonight. Amen.
Not a word was heard at the tomb that day, just shuffling soldiers' feet as they guarded the grave. One day, 2 days, 3 days had passed. Could it be that Jesus breathed his last? Could it be that his Father had forsaken him, turned his back on his Son, despising our sin? All hell seemed to whisper, just forget him, he's dead. Then the Father looked down to his Son and he said, and the tomb began to shake, and like lightning from heaven, that old stone was rolled away. And instead of the guards, they all stood there in fright as the power of love displayed.
Arise, my love, arise, my love, the rain.
Let me just take just a second right here, just for a second, and we're going to move on really quick. But let me just tell you this, he's only coming back for those that are ready. And this is a gospel, you know, concert, Christian concert, whatever you want to call it. And, you know, you just never know who comes to these things. Some of you are here because you love Southern gospel music. Some of you here because somebody drugged you here. Some of you might have been drugged and then brought here. We just never know how people show up at these things. But, man, let me just say this. If you're depending on anything else but Jesus Christ to get you to heaven, you're in a world of hurt. You're in a lot of trouble. So I hope tonight you're not depending on your denomination. I hope tonight that you're not depending on your good works. I hope tonight that you're not depending on the fact that you're a good person or that you give a lot of money. I hope tonight that you're depending on Jesus Christ and Him only. Because He said He is the way, the truth, and the life. Any man want to see the Father, any man want to go to heaven, you got to go through Him tonight. And so if there's one here tonight, you're just like, man, I don't know if I've ever, these gospel songs, they've gotten to me. I don't know if I've ever really surrendered my life to the Lord or not. Apostle Paul said in 2 Corinthians 13:5, to examine yourself. See if you be in the faith. Is Jesus Christ living in you? Examine yourself. Take just a few moments tonight. Listen, we want you to enjoy the concert, but just take just a few moments tonight just to make sure that He knows who you are and you know who He is for sure. Don't you dare leave this place tonight without knowing for sure that you belong to Jesus Christ. I want us to bow just for a moment. I don't want to drag this. I'm going to bow. I want you to bow with me just for a moment, if you would. Even the choir, if you guys would bow just for a moment. And I just want you to take just a second, just examine your heart. Do you know for sure tonight, if Jesus were to come, that you'd go to meet Him? Is there any doubt whatsoever that one of these days you're going to hear Him say, "Well done, good and faithful servant"? If there is, there doesn't have to be. Tonight, right where you're sitting tonight, you don't have to come up here and fill out a card. You don't have to come up here and shake my hand. Right where you're sitting tonight, you can surrender your life to Christ. The Apostle Paul said it like this, "For whosoever should call upon His name can be saved." The Lord made it that simple. Whosoever shall call upon His name can be saved. For as many as received Him, to them gave He power to become the sons and daughters of God. So right where you're sitting, I can't tell you what to pray. I can just say from your heart to His heart, why don't you call out to Him tonight? God, we love You and we're so thankful that You showed up in this place tonight. Obviously through every group that's been here tonight, God, You have just moved and we felt Your presence. And God, I know that You've wanted to touch each and every person here. Lord, let this not be just another concert, just another singing, but Lord, a life-changing event for somebody here tonight in this place. Would You move? Would You have Your way? In Jesus' precious and holy name, and all of God's people said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Have you enjoyed these fellows so far? We got a couple more things we want to do for you. I want to say really quick, our bus driver's back there, Chad, our sound man, sound engineer, Adam, is fantastic. They've been both doing a great job. Adam's got his family back there. It's just awesome. You got David, Scotty, Clayton. I'm Eric. We're thrilled to be here. And how many of you like bluegrass music? I got to be honest. We love it when the primitive does it, right? Not so much when we try to do it. But we've had a couple requests for this song, and well, actually, Clayton requested it a couple times. Features him. He loves to hear himself sing. But anyhow, we feel like to like bluegrass, you probably need to be raised on it. We're losing. People are leaving already in the bluegrass. Hey, hang on, we'll go with you. If you enjoy this, I want you to let him know. If you don't, just sit there and stare at it.
Hey, lost sinner man, don't you know you can't win if you keep on. listening to the devil's lies, burdened down so low. You found out that a sinner's life is a minor hard road to hoe.
Why don't you just wave that old white flag of surrender? Come down to the altar, lift our steadfast soul in there. And you can run from the Lord, just so far back that you can't remember. Let it ease your troubled mind and wash your sins away. Yeah.
See through your tears. I can see you staring at the preacher's face, his words just calm your fears. And there you go, running down the aisle, about to be born again. Very soon you can use this old white flag to preach to your sinner friends.
Why don't you just wave that old white flag of surrender? Come down to the altar, let God save our soul today. Now you run from the Lord, just so far back and you can't remember. Let it ease your troubled mind and wash your sins away. Hey, why don't you just wave that old white flag of surrender? Come down to the altar,
let God save our soul today. Sins away.
Let him wash your sins away.
Do you wanna go? Do you wanna go? Do you?
Are y'all going to sing I'm Going There yet? I haven't heard it.
Well, let's sing it again, Al.
I'm going there.
Are you?